Welcome back to Curiosity Kids. I'm Joy with ACCPF.
I'm Quinn, my daughter.
And we have been learning about birding or birding basics. So we have learned so far how to find a safe sit spot, right? You remember what that needed?
A towel?
Like something to sit on, shade. Don't sit in prickly bushes, that kind of thing, right? To look for birds by looking for signs of birds. I was wondering what we do when we actually see birds. What do you think?
Probably get our binoculars and look at them.
We should get our binoculars and look at them?
And like record it in our nature.
So we've learned all those things, but...
How do you like identify a bird?
How do you identify a bird? I don't know. I don't know how you ID bird. Well, I think we could ask Miss Carrie, the school garden doctor, how we identify birds.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Birding Basics with Miss Carrie as part of Curiosity Kids. There's a lot of bird activity in my backyard right now, including my chickens. In today's video, I'll discuss some of the most important tips to keep in mind when trying to identify birds. I'm going to share just a couple of tools that I like to use when working on bird identification. My favorite field guide is Stokes Beginner's Guide to Western Region. This guide is handily organized according to color. So if you find a bird and you don't know what it is, it's easy to look up just based on the color. Another guide I like is the Local Birds of Northern California. This is a waterproof pocket guide. So it folds up and is organized by different kinds of birds that you find in different areas. For example, the back side has mostly water birds, and the front side has mostly backyard birds or woodland birds, including songbirds. This is a really handy one, the Laws Pocket Guide to Yard and Garden Birds of the San Francisco Bay Area. This gets even closer to home, has almost all the birds that I commonly see in my backyard. Finally, you might find just other kinds of collections. For example, this one is from the Center for Land-Based Learning. And I like to use this one for birds that are common because of their images. So this one has an image of the great egret, and it gives a lot of good information on the back about their habits. Some birds are more common at the shoreline, like the wetland's edge in American Canyon, and others can only be found in a forest. But there are many kinds of birds that can be found right in your own backyard. When you see a bird, you'll want to pay attention to its size and its color. Birds range in size from smaller than a fist to larger than a cat. Most birds that live in our area are just a few colors. In fact, mostly one or two. A northern mockingbird is a really common bird in area gardens or parks or open spaces. It's mostly gray, with a little bit of black and white coloring, but its distinct feature is a really long tail. A yellow-rumped warbler is also mostly gray, but it's smaller than a robin, more the size of a sparrow or a chickadee. This bird has a little yellow patch on the front of each wing and a distinctive yellow patch on its back side. For this reason, it's sometimes called a butterbutt. Sometimes when I go out to watch birds, I don't see that many birds. There's nothing to identify by sight. But I might sit down in my sit spot and make a journal entry anyway, and I try to keep track of the different birds that I hear. Other times, I see birds that I already know, but they're doing something really interesting or noteworthy, and I might make a journal entry about that as well. Whether you're seeing birds or hearing birds, if you identify a bird, it's really fun to keep track of it. People who've been birding a long time keep track of rare sightings. They sometimes call this their life list. But I find that any bird makes a good addition to my list. Happy birding!
Thank you, Miss Carrie. That was really cool. So I think I've learned a few things this time. You can identify birds by their color and their size and their sound. You're right. She said, listen to the birds because sometimes that's how you know where they are, even if you can't see them. So now are you ready to grab our binoculars and our journal and get outside?
Yes.
see if we can find some birds.
Nature Lover.
So if you are ready to get outside and you need a little bit more information, make sure to check out acparks.org, and you can download your instruction and references for those cool guides that Miss Carrie showed us. And get outside and have some fun.
Bye.